Barbershop Talk with Bedoe the Barber. And today we're here with Miles Pepper with the St. Louis Trotters. How you doing today?
How you doing? I'm all right.
All right, all right. And today we're going to be just giving us a little insight about what's going on with the Trotters, with how they got started, and where it all stemmed from. So just give us a little information on how the Trotters come about.
Actually, we started back in the late 70s. My coach, my head coach, and GM, Earl Webster, he started a Trotters organization as an AAU program. He was the first AAU program in the Midwest when he started back in like 76. So he started doing a lot of traveling then, so once he got that going, there's a lot of guys that play with the team, eventually start playing with us.
Okay.
Pretty good start how we started off early.
And how long have you all been a semi-pro?
Been a semi-pro for 2 years now. We started in 2012.
Okay, 2012. Now your record, if I'm not, correct me if I'm wrong, 5-1?
6-1.
6-1 from the game.
Yeah, one last night.
Just one last night. And then just put up a winning seat, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good. That's what's up, man. Now, what type of things does the organization do outside of, you know, when you guys are not playing ball? What type of things do you do? Community.
Yeah, we do a lot of community events. We did a basketball camp for autism kids in January. Then we did another outing event at the art gallery called Black Fatherhood. Me and a lot of my players went out there and talked to the community, you know, how to be positive role models for the community. So, did that really well. And, we have a couple more events coming up. I got a couple of fundraisers coming up next month. In May, June, all summer. Let's keep our name going out there.
Right, right. And so you guys have a pretty tight schedule.
Yes, yeah, yeah. All week.
Now, your next game, who are you playing and where are they going to be put
out? We're playing at Wolf this Saturday, May the 3rd, against Kansas City County Soldiers. This will be a rematch of, they beat us in the championship last session. So, yeah, we're the last two teams that play, so we got to. Chip on my shoulder and then
change it.
Okay, I'm out of play.
Right, right, all right, all right. So, how many, this is for our team, so how many players are on the team?
We hold 15.
15 teams to a roster.
Okay, 15 to a roster.
Okay. And,
is there any
special type of, between you and the players and the team, is there any special type of firing that goes back before the team's put together?
Yeah, or? Yeah. Most of us, we played together for so long, so we kind of like a family. Okay, once I started the team, you know, you can go against certain guys that you want to come run with. So, okay. I already had in my mind who my hard-hitting guys were, so it's like we track them, get their interest in playing professional ball, get them opportunity to play. OC, NBA, NBA, wherever.
Right.
You know, that's when I started the team, really to get back for the guys who really looked at the club. Because when I came out of school, they didn't really have no pro team. So,
right.
So I said, well, let me get back this way. So I started the team, let people get games, get them stats, get the ball, you know, get the A's and go off the field.
Now, by us not having a pro team here in St. Louis, you guys are giving us that opportunity. We do appreciate that. Great. Now, how does the city, your personal opinion on how the city outlooks? Look at you all.
They see us all good because like, we do a lot of stuff in the community, so I've been getting a lot of emails, a lot of, you know, text messages, and things to congratulate how we've been doing. So I've been getting a lot of good positive feedback. Even people who I work with, they're like, well, they keep me doing a good job. So that stuff really keeps me going. And I can send it on to my teammates, and they help keep me going.
And how often do you want games that you all hold?
Just about every week.
Okay.
So, normally the game starts at 7.
Okay.
7 and it lasts about 2 hours.
And then you're usually around
community. Yeah, we try to keep it in the community. Right? Yeah, Magic City.
Like, old Magic City. Okay, cool. That's what's up, man. Same with Trotters. Yeah, it's good. Yeah, it sounds like a basketball team here. You know what I'm saying?
It's been a while.
Yeah, it's been a while. They've been fighting, trying to get an NBA team, but I think semi-pro team is a good start. To see if they're willing to accept that as important. And I see that they are supporting what we're doing, so, you know, hopefully we're going to something. But as far as right now, I'm speaking for everybody. We probably have to go appreciate it. appreciate you coming in today and taking time to interview with us. Is there anything that you want to talk about, let the people know out there?
We really just need like a lot of support, from fans and for whoever out in the community come check us out. So, like family entertainment, we got DJs playing, we got a lot of giveaways in the game. So, and before I came, got like kids, we like to promote human basketball too. So, we got them come and play for us so they can get the idea of what it takes to be professional, right? So, when they do that, so we do that, we have a lot of halftime performers come in, we might have some singers, rappers, and we have like dance group, they come in and perform. So, we try to get back into it when we can.
Now, if there's anybody who wanted to get involved in the performing and helping out and volunteering and things like that,
they can contact us on the website, sacredstarts.com.
Okay, cool. Okay, that's great. All right. Well, welcome everybody. I'd like to say, once again, for another edition of Barbershop Talk here with Live DVD. My man, Wilden here. So, man, we go to Barb. We'll see you soon. Come check us out, 4815 page. 314-536-6381. That's 6 St. Louis, Missouri 63113.